Jai Narayan, dear students. I hope you all are fine. Today, the weather is quite rainy. So in this weather, you need to keep yourself dry. And if you get drenched in the rain because of some reason, then you need to drink the kadha and follow the rules of SMS. That would be protecting your body. That would be giving you immunity. So, till now, dear students, we studied in the chapter Discovering Tat, the saga continues. We studied that about the death of King Tat. King Tat was just a teenager when he died. He was the last heir of the powerful family that had ruled Egypt and its empire for centuries. He was buried and forgotten over the years. But after the discovery of his tomb in the year 1922, the modern world wondered about the cause of his untimely death. He was brought out of his tomb, and recently a CT scan was done to ascertain the reason of his death. So, King Tut was just, we come to know that King Tut was just a teenager when he met with his death. And he was the last heir of his whole empire, his whole family. And his empire, his dynasty was very powerful. They ruled over Egypt for centuries. And he was laid to rest in a grave that was laden with gold. And finally, he was forgotten. When in the year 1922, his tomb was discovered, it aroused curiosity of the people to know about King Tut. So, for that, a CT scan was done on his dead body. It offered new clues about his life and death. Now, let's move further. So, dear students, in front of you is the place where King Tut was being buried. And this is the face mask of Tutankhamun's mummy. Now let's move further. So that whole afternoon, the tourists, they kept on visiting the 26 feet deep underground rock cut tomb, and they kept on visiting simply to pay respect to the King Tut. Many people, they entered into that small tomb and they looked in admiration at the murals on the walls of the chamber and took a look at the face of Tut that had been painted with gold. Murals means the decoration, the artifacts which were there on the walls. So, while visitors, some of the visitors, they were reading the guidebooks in a hushed tone. Some of the visitors, they stood there silently, wondering about his untimely death, and that also in his teen years. There, they might also be wondering if the curse of the pharaoh, it would lead to the descent of misfortune upon the person who had disturbed him could be true. Now comes the new character, Zahi Hawass. Zahi Hawass, he is the Secretary General of Egypt. When he leaned over King Tut's body to have a look, he said that the mummy was in a very pitiable condition because of what the archaeologist Howard Carter did to it. And that also in the year 1922, because he had discovered the King Tut's tomb in the year 1922. So, the valuable treasures of Tut had been explored earlier too, but surprisingly, they were complete. The treasure found at Tut's grave is the richest till date and had come to be known as the Pharaoh's legend. It has artifacts in gold, which are eternally beautiful and as good as new. Such artifacts, they still get attention. Tut was buried with things of daily use, which he used in his daily life, like garments, food, wine, bronze, razor, and games. So now, Carter, he took a few months to record the treasure found in Tut's grave. And after investigating the treasure, he began investigating his three coffins, which were nested one in another. In the first coffin, he found a piece of cloth with garland of willow, olive leaves, wild celery, lotus petals, and cornflower, which suggested that possibly he was being buried in the month of either March or April. So when Carter reached the third coffin, he was in trouble. The body had hardened due to the raisins which had cemented the body, and it had stuck to the bottom of the coffin, which was made of gold. Carter here wondered what to do next, because no amount of force could separate the two. Carter, he tried to loosen the raisins by keeping the body in the hot sun. He kept the mummy in 149 degree Fahrenheit heat for several hours, but still it remained stuck. He reported that a chisel could be used to cut down the mummy from the limbs and the trunk so that Tut's body could be taken out of the coffin. And according to Carter, he had no choice other than to chisel the mummy's part. He believed that if he hadn't done that, thieves, they would have removed the gold from the tomb and would have looted it. So, during Tut's time, the royal people, they were very wealthy, and they had a belief that life is there after death, and there they could take the wealth along with them. So for his life, for King Tut's life after death, he was given precious things like necklace, decorative pattern, bracelet, amulets, ceremonial aprons, sandals, and many other things. So when Carter's men, they removed his head and every joint of his body to take his body out from the coffin. After they had finished, they once again reassembled the remains in a wooden box, this time with paddling filled with a layer of sand to conceal the damage. And now the wooden box layered with sand was his now new resting place. Now comes, in the past few decades, archaeology, it has changed a lot, as now it focuses on the details of life and the mysteries of death. Earlier, it was focusing on the treasure. Now, it uses more advanced medical technologies and tools for research. In the year 1968, an anatomy professor, he x-rayed King Tut's mummy and revealed that the front limbs and breastbone, they were missing. So now, with the advancement of technology, CT scan, or CT means computed tomography, it can give a virtual image of the whole world. With the help of this technology, King Tut's body would be scanned to find out answers to two questions. These are the two unanswered questions: how he died and how old was he at the time of his death. His death was a shock to the royals also, as he was the last person of his family and his funeral indicated the diminishment of his dynasty. However, what happened after his death is still not clear. Now, King Tut's lineage and reign. King Tut's father or grandfather, Amenhotep III, he was a very powerful pharaoh who ruled for a period of approximately 40 years. His son, Amenhotep IV, succeeded him and began the strangest period in the history of Egypt. He promoted the worship of Aten, the sun disk. He changed his name also to Akhenaten, meaning servant of the Aten. He also shifted the religious capital from Thebes to the new city of Akhenaten called Amarna. Further, he attacked Amun, a god, smashed his images and closed all his temples. Ray Johnson, the director of the University of Chicago, said that it must have been a bad time for the empire as the family who ruled for centuries came to an end and Akhenaten moved in an odd direction. So, another mysterious ruler, Smenkhkare, he succeeded him, but he died very soon. The next king to sit over the throne was Tutankhamun, also known as Tut. He sat on the throne and ruled for approximately 9 years. He worshipped God Amun in the old way. However, he died mysteriously. So, Tut is one of the mummies in Egypt. Whereas until now, with the help of Egyptian Mummy Project, which started in 2003, almost 600 mummies they have been recorded so far. King Tut's mummy was the first one to be scanned by Citi under the next phase of scanning. The mummies with the machine donated by National Geographic Society and Siemens. The CT scan machine scanned the body by creating 1700 digital X-rays in cross-section. Tut's head was scanned in 0.62 millimeter slices to record the very tiny details, and the resulting image were very strong. A team of radiology, forensic and anatomy experts, they started examining the secrets of the grave that had been protected by flying goddess for a long time. Now, during the night, the workmen, they climbed upon the ramp and upon the flight of stairs simply to carry the body from the grave to the trailer where the scanning was to take place. So they rose the body onto the hydraulic lift. Then they went into the trailer. And there was the place where the scanner was kept. And after 20 minutes, two men, they came running towards the office, which was very nearby, to bring two fans. The scanner was not working because the sand had entered a cooler fan. One of the guard, he joked that it was because of the curse of the pharaoh that they had removed the body from his grave. So the curse of the pharaoh was falling upon it. But once again, the fan, it started working and the procedure was finished. The data was checked in case of any loss, and then technicians, they returned the body to the pallbearers who carried him back to his tomb. So in less than 3 hours, he was once again resting at the same place where the priest might have buried him several years ago. So once again, King Tut's body after the scanning was resting in peace in his tomb. Now, once again, in the trailer, the technician, he showed a beautiful image of Tut on a computer screen. He showed how the grey head was, with the help of scattered pixels, was being built. The vertebrae, hand, ribcage and his skull, they all were seen on the screen. When the work was completed, now the Zahi Hawass felt that the pressure was now off from his shoulders. So now while he was sitting on the chair, he gave a smile and said that he was quite relieved that nothing wrong had went, and now that he wanted to have a very good sound sleep. So he started leaving the trailer. By the time they left the trailer, the wind, which was blowing very heavily, it had stopped and the winter air was blowing. Just above the tomb, the Orion constellation shone in the night sky that was watching over the boy king. So, dear students, in today's lecture, we studied that how Howard Carter, he tried to loosen the raisin by using the sun, but it went in vain. His men, thus they removed the mummy's head and cut off nearly every major joint before reassembling it. In 1968, an anatomy professor x-rayed the mummy and revealed the startling fact. He claimed that the breastbone and the front ribs of the mummy, they were missing. Now comes Amenhotep III. He was King Tut's father or grandfather. He was a very powerful king and he was being succeeded by Amenhotep IV, who promoted the worship of Aten, the sun disk, and he himself changed his name to Akhenaten. He made some other changes also. King Tut's mummy was one of the first mummies to be scanned. The CT scan showed a grey head, neck, vertebrae, a hand and several images of the rib cage and a section of the skull. Zahi Hawass was relieved to find that nothing had gone seriously wrong with the mummy. After their observations, when they left, the wind had stopped and there was complete silence. Just above the entrance of King Tut's tomb stood Orion, the constellation, watching over the boy king. So that was it in the chapter, dear students. I hope you have all understood it. If you have any queries, please feel free to ask. Jai Narayan.